gold mine. You could kill a dig. Come and see, come and see for your bag. Come and see back your bag.
You're far.
I just imagine what the match. You control the match.
Alright, I package this real package. Holy goal. Kyle. Yo, no sir. Goal mine.
In 2023, there was buzz in the community of Chester Castle, Hanover, Jamaica. This buzz revolved around the finding of gold by community residents. It was eventually determined that the gold found was that of fool's gold, or scientifically known as pyrite. Understandably, there was much disappointment amongst the community residents, especially that of the property owner, whose property was dug up. Now, having the scientific mind that I have, I cannot leave this mystery alone. The mystery of how pyrite could have formed and as such be found within the community of Chester Castle, as well as could it be that pyrite being found also is an indicator that there are or there could be true gold or pure gold nearby. The chemical makeup of pyrite is that of iron and sulfur. Now, in terms of its occurrence, naturally, pyrite can occur in igneous rocks or rocks that are derived from magma or lava from within the earth, metamorphic rocks, rocks that are made as a result of high temperature as well as higher pressure that is greater than that of the diagenetic boundary, as well as sedimentary rocks, rocks that are made as a result of compaction and can occur at the Earth's surface and can go to depths that do not go beyond that of the diagenetic boundary or pressure boundary. Now, using the geology map provided by Professor Simon Mitchell, what we can see is that pyrite, as was found, could have been formed as a result of igneous rocks and potentially both metamorphic and sedimentary rocks. Using the Google satellite imagery as reference, what we can see is that Chester Castle is primarily located or situated within a plain, and there exists carbonate rocks around it primarily. When we add the scenes of this video, what we see is gray colored as well as yellow brown colored layers of sediment. This sediment, relatively speaking, is classified as silt and clay in terms of its particle size. Now, if we're going to use the scenes of this video, we are potentially going to arrive at the conclusion that this pyrite was formed in sedimentary rock environments. Again, referencing the Google satellite imagery, this can be supported by what it is that we can see as carbonate as well as alluvium environment that surrounds the Chester Castle community. Having said this, we should not ignore what it is that the geology map of that of Professor Simon Mitchell is saying, and that is there exists igneous rocks, and these igneous rocks potentially could have in a source rock or source environment for this pyrite formation. The gray areas of these sediments that's dug up is what is interesting. Carbonates won't generally provide us with gray layers. They more so will provide us with the yellow orange layers that we can see in the video. This gray layer could be derived from organic matter, and this organic matter could have been derived from shales or mudstone. However, it is also likely that this gray area could have been derived from volcanic ash. So, with that being said, it is a potential reality that the environment that supported the pyrite formation could have been joint igneous and sedimentary. And on that note, it is also likely that there could be pure gold that is around this region that includes that of the igneous source rocks as well as that of the carbonates / limestone rocks as well as the alluvium. Keep in mind that the overall geology is a very complex one that's supported by the high faulting as well as folding surfaces. In other words, subsurface mapping is indeed necessary to be able to determine whether or not this theory is true. But either way, just on the basis of what was found, there is indication there that there could be pure gold nearby.